Lindsey Graham was born Lindsey Ashford Graham in Springfield, Missouri on June 17, 1957. From an early age, Lindsey was fascinated by the kitchen. He would often skip school to spend time perfecting gnocchi and enjoyed serving up countless pounds of his signature beef Wellington. "The secret is in the sauce," Graham would say to his dinner guests, mostly comprised of his family and collection of sock puppets stacked on the dinner table. His fledgling cooking career was nearly brought to a halt when a candle was knocked over, burning many of his socks, which acted as kindling for the dining room's lace curtains. His sock puppet collection was never the same after that. Soon, he would drop out of school to open his own bakery. He found early success making erotic cakes for the Springfield socialite scene. However, it was during one Sabbath Eve in 1974 where Lindsey would create his namesake dish. Combining flour, lard, oil, molasses, and honey, he called it the Lindsey Cracker. Offering free samples at his bakery, he would invite his guests to put Lindsey in their mouth and suggest Lindsey is best when he's all sticky and covered in honey. People agreed, and it wasn't long before thousands were stopping by to take Lindsey home to their family. There were lots of different ways people would eat the Lindsey Cracker. Some would cover Lindsey with cream cheese. Others would toast Lindsey with chocolate and marshmallows and joke, "Gimme some more Lindsey." People would even have contests, seeing how much Lindsey they could stuff in their mouth at one time. Sadly, it was at one of these contests where a person had too much Lindsey inside them and choked to death. Saddened that his creation could do harm, Lindsey pulled the crackers from the market for a couple months. After rethinking the design, he added perforations to the cracker so that it could be broken apart into smaller pieces. He also renamed it the Graham Cracker to further separate himself from the tragic incident. Yes, Lindsey Graham is one big cracker. And now you know the rest of the story. This is False Facts. Good day.